arranging joints.
Hi everyone, I am Kenan from OneChain, and this video will be a guide on how to buy and sell OneChain for fiat currency. Keep in mind, this video is only part one, because in the near future will be more integration and more updates regarding this service. Okay, so first of all, in this video, guys, step by step, I have a special guest with me today, and his name is Sergiu Drăgănuș. He is the founder of CryptoCoin.pro, and Sergiu and his team will provide to OneChain a fiat to crypto ramp on, ramp off service via major credit card payments and bank transfer. Sergiu, how are you today?
Hi, Ovidiu. I'm fine, thank you.
So tell us a bit about your journey in this blockchain space.
Yeah, so basically I've interacted for the first time with Bitcoin basically back in 2012 on Meetup in London. It was a very interesting thing. I was there with another topic, and I thought it's a good moment to find out more about the big Bitcoin phenomenon. It was around, I don't know, $10-$12 the Bitcoin at that moment, and was an interesting meeting. At that moment, I was convinced by the guys from Butterfly Labs to buy some mining equipments. They were impressive ASIC mining equipments. By doing short math, you could realize that the profits are huge. And this was basically my first experience with crypto space. I've ordered the first equipments. They got to my address 2-3 weeks later. I start mining. I was doing a Bitcoin every, 1 day and a half or something like this. A Bitcoin, so it was something amazing. And I choose to buy much more equipment. And that order, the second order, never was delivered because Butterfly Labs fill in for bankruptcy. So this was my initial touch with the crypto space. Up to 2016, I was only following remote, to say so, the Bitcoin phenomenon. And in 2016, I started being a marketing advisor for one project. Plus, I've attended to an event in Vienna. Pioneers event, and there was a workshop for about the DAO. The DAO was basically the second project that sounds more than amazing, decentralized companies, management, voting. This is what they are talking, and that was the first time hearing about everything else that can be done over the blockchain, that only value transfer, okay? So obviously that I was convinced to invest again. And as we all know, the DAO was the main reason for the Ethereum fork, Ethereum and Ethereum Classic, because they discover an exploit in the initial code of it. So it was my second time when I was losing into the crypto investments. But step by step, I become much more interested by this phenomenon. And in 2017, we've decided, together with my partners, we decided to create a system where everyone holding a credit card or a bank transfer to be able to buy crypto easily. In 2017, it was pretty difficult to buy Bitcoin or Ethereum easily in a compliant and regulated way. Our vision from the beginning was that the compliant part is very important, because without being compliant, we'll never be able to really scale up a business in partnership with Visa, with MasterCard, or with the traditional banking systems, which would finally lead to mass adoption. If we want mass adoption, we really want to have very good connections with the traditional systems. Yeah. So we got our licenses, and we start creating the system. At the beginning was a simple brokerage system with a simple graphical user interface, so anyone was able to buy $50 worth of Bitcoin, 100, 1,000 or more. And the business went for the pretty good, pretty well. Obviously, the ICO rush came when we thought it's a good moment to customize a little bit our projects, our project to offer some specific type of services for the ICO, needs. And we've created this platform, our last ICO launchpad. Our turnover was close to $100 million during the, let's call it, ICO rush. But this was for a limited period of time. And we had to do the next step. What we've understood in those few years of interacting with several crypto projects, where we are either partners, advisors, or simple consultants, we've understood that all of them are facing a major problem. If they want to be listed, if they want to offer, if they want to go to mass adoption, they need to offer an easy way in and out from fiat to their tokens. Yeah. And the first thing all of us were thinking about was, okay, I need to be listed on Binance or Kraken, on the main exchanges. But as we all know, it's not so easy to get listed on those exchanges, first of all. And even for some of the best projects which are already listed there, once you are listed, for a normal internet user, it's not simple to go on one platform, to create a wallet, to go through the whole KYC process, which sometimes it's easier, sometimes it's more complex. And after this step, to go to another platform to buy the crypto, Bitcoin or Ether, to send it to that specific platform and to do the swap, the exchange on Binance, for example, because Binance until a few months ago didn't offer an easy way in for fiat. Okay, so, and plus there are many other exchange platform that even now does not offer an easy way for fiat in and fiat out. For me, my first experience when I've created an account on exchange was on Poloniex. And I remember looking to those charts and didn't understand nothing from those candles and sticks and going up and going down. And obviously I need to take some Udemy courses to understand how everything is going. So we thought it's very good for the projects to be listed on those main exchanges. It's very clear that this offers a huge awareness and notoriety to the user base of those specific exchanges. But it should be amazing for those projects to have an easy way in and out for fiat in their current wallets, blockchain explorers, and apps. Okay. To do this, we've done this at CryptoCoin Pro, and we understand the hassle behind of it. So basically, we need to, the company need to go and get licenses first of all, and after they need to hire their compliance departments. They need to define procedures, and after they need to start implementation. And we're talking about several million of dollars to have the solution ready. The maintenance of the solution is also very expensive. And this does not make sense. Basically, let's think for an e-commerce and PayPal. When an e-commerce wants to accept online payments, one of the solutions they choose is PayPal. It's an easy implementation, it's free, does not cost nothing, only a small fee of the amount. This is the same way we are running CryptoCoin Pro. So currently we are going with zero setup fees for the project and a small fee for each different transaction. And this fee, it's used to be paid to pay the licenses part, the compliance department, the technical, the maintenance, the servers, the cybersecurity, and everything else related to it. Basically, let's tell it like this, it's basically a small fraction of the whole cost that the platform has. And this is a very good value proposal for any project willing to go to mass adoption, obviously. So more or less, this is my history from 2012 to 2020 on crypto space, on blockchain, in only a few words. Yeah.
Very nice background over there. Let's start with the step-by-step guide on how to use this service.
So here you go. Please perfect. Let me know if you can see my screen right now.
Yes, it's perfect.
Excellent. So as you can see, the graphical user interface, let me zoom in a little bit more. It's a simple one. It's a pretty simple one where you select basically what you want to either buy or sell. Yeah. In this case, it's one chain. We're talking about one chain. You select in euros the amount you want to buy, for example, or the number of one that you want to buy. And here I would select, let's call it 100 euros worth of one. And you select the operation, either buy or sell. Yes? As you can see here, the fee to buy 100 euros worth of one is exactly 3 euros. Or in one, 18.34 and so on. If you choose the bank transfer. If you choose the credit card, is 3.568. Please note that this fee includes our platform fee plus the credit card processing fee. So basically, there is not an additional fee that need to be paid for the Visa, for Visa and MasterCard. As you probably know, on some platform, you'll find only the credit card processing fee going up to 3.5-4.5%, because usually those type of services are considered high risk services, and usually the payment gateways are charging a pretty high fee on this. But because currently we are running some pretty secure system of analyzing those transactions, we were able to cut the fraud risk to zero in the last 12 months. And basically, because the risk is zero or very close to zero right now, we are not overcharging the final client extra money to cover a risk. Yeah. So I think this is a very important aspect. Only for the audience to know, we're analyzing in real time over 100 specific factors which help us identify that the transaction is a fraudulent one or if the transaction it's a correct one.
Okay. Yeah, so Sergio, tell us if you do this transaction with buying 100 euros for one, how much time will occur the transaction to be complete?
There are two specific cases. It depends. If it's first time when you do the transaction, you will go via a short identification process. It's normal for us to ask more detail about email address, phone number, and an ID. Yes. Yes. Once this was done for the first time, second time you'll be only identified with a code sent by your email or by your phone number, and the KYC stays. So at the beginning, might take several hours, depending on the load of the platform, for the KYC to be approved.
Okay, after the KYC is done, let's say I'm doing the third transaction, no?
And, after the KYC is done, when you're doing the third transaction, let's call it, it should take like 30 minutes, 45 minutes, more or less, something like this. It always depends, again, on the load that we have on the other transactions. But it will not take more for the one to be in your account.
Nice, very nice, very, very nice.
This is from the moment when the payment with the credit card is confirmed by our payment gateway. Usually it takes seconds to be confirmed. Yes. Now, if we are talking about bank transfer, because for larger amounts, bank transfer, it's a better solution. It's obviously one, it's almost more or less 1% different between those two payment types. And on the bank transfer, currently we are operating Euro bank account, including SEPA transfer. So if someone choose to use to send a SEPA transfer, it can take from 40-50 minutes for the funds to be in our account to up to 24 hours. But 24 hours, it's maximum it can take. Usually take an average 12-14 hours to be confirmed under our account. Once it's confirmed on our under our account, then we'll release the funds to the client. But what is very important, we will keep the same rate. So if the price of one would double during this period of time, we'll not send only half of them back to the client. Not. So when the client has choose buy, bank transfer, has entered his wallet and click next and accepted our order, the client will have 60 minutes time to upload the proof of payment. This could be a screenshot from his phone or from his banking account, the proof that he sent the money. This is more than enough for now to hedge, for us to buy, to really buy in the same amount that they've ordered. So after this, we'll only wait for the money to arrive to our account. And once the money arrives to our account, we'll click the release button and they will get the one.
Yes, yes. Very, very nice and very easy, I must say. It's not nothing complicated.
We've tried to do it as easy as possible. And our current partnerships running this sort of implementations are very happy with it. their clients are happy with it, and we are also happy with it that we can deliver the service, you know. So yeah,
I think that's it for this video. So thank you so much, Sergio, for your collaboration and your time, and we will keep in touch for the future updates. Okay,
thank you Ovidiu.
Thank you so much. Yep. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
We are Wenqing. Join us.